Hi, I am Georgios Papadopoulos and welcome to this video on 6LoWPAN fragmentation and reassembly mechanism defined in RFC 4944. The 6LoWPAN adaptation layer defines compression, fragmentation and reassembly and frame delivery mechanisms for IPv6 datagrams. As specified in RFC 4944, when a compressed IPv6 datagram does not fit within a single IEEE 802.15.4 frame, then fragmentation operation is required to split the large datagram into multiple fragments of up to 127 bytes. Let us now dive deeper to see the whole process of 6LoWPAN fragmentation and reassembly operation. To enable the fragmentation and reassembly operations, 6LoWPAN defines two fragment headers, where the header for the first fragment consists of 4 bytes, while the header for the subsequent fragments of 5 bytes. More specifically, the fragment headers come with the following fields. First, we have the datagram size. This first field is employed to encode the size of the original IPv6 datagram. The second field is the datagram tag. This field, in conjunction with the MAC source address, is employed to identify all fragments of a single IPv6 datagram. The third and the last field is the datagram offset. This field is included only in the second and subsequent fragments of an IPv6 datagram, and it specifies the offset in increments of 8 bytes. In other words, it identifies the relative position of the received fragment from the beginning of the payload datagram to enable thus out-of-sequence delivery. Here we have the fragmentation type and header format for the first fragment, where the first 5 bits of dispatch while bit pattern indicates the fragmentation type. In this case, it is equal to 11000, which represents the first fragment of an IPv6 datagram. While in the figure below, the first 5 bits is equal to 11100, which represents the second or subsequent fragment of an IPv6 datagram. The receiving node, upon receipt of a fragment, initiates the reassembly operation to reconstruct the original unfragmented IPv6 datagram, whose size is datagram size. Toward the same, the receiver checks the datagram tag field to identify all the fragments that belong to a given IPv6 datagram. Next, it checks the datagram offset to determine the location of the received individual fragment within the original unfragmented datagram. Finally, the receiver checks the datagram size field to identify the size of the original unfragmented datagram and consequently the size of the reassembly buffer. Furthermore, once a receiver successfully receives a new fragment with a certain datagram tag value, it initiates a reassembly timer. The value of this reassembly timeout must be configured to a maximum of 60 seconds, which is the timeout in the IPv6 reassembly procedure. If the IPv6 datagram has not been reconstructed within this time, the reassembly operation is aborted while the received fragments are discarded. In our video RFC 4944, 6LoWPAN frame delivery modes, we are going to see how the fragmented frames are delivered to the final destination. Finally, you might have noticed that IPv6 header is missing from the subsequent fragments. In our video RFC 8930, 6LoWPAN fragment forwarding, or 6LFF, we explain how these subsequent fragments are forwarded without the use of the IPv6.